Hello, this is Tom Mack, Technical Support Specialist at Bacharach Incorporated. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about the replacement of the oxygen sensor in the FireRite InTech and the FireRite Insight Plus. This is a call we get rather frequently, so we're going to go over it step by step, even though it's explained in the manual. We'll go over it step by step with you and describe what needs to be done. Now, the FireRite InTech and FireRite Insight Plus are very similar instruments in the oxygen cell area. The FireRite InTech has a 2-year oxygen sensor that comes in a package like this. The FireRite Insight Plus also uses this sensor, but there's an option for a long life sensor which comes in a package like this. Whichever one you have to record the date code off the side of the sensor, which we'll cover in a moment. The FireRite InTech and the FireRite Insight Plus, for demonstration purposes, I'll be using the FireRite InTech. Now, the FireRite InTech, you have a battery door in the back. You remove the cover from the battery door. After removing that, your next step is to remove the hose from the oxygen sensor. In the FireRite InTech and the Insight Plus, the oxygen sensor is the one on the left-hand side when looking from the back. You'll remove the tubing from that sensor. After it is removed, you then proceed to grab the sensor by the removal tab that's on there, pull straight up on it, and the entire sensor comes out. Once that sensor is removed, what you want to do is take off the cap, which is a bayonet mount, 1/4 turn removal, and pull the cap off. You then take your new sensor, and prior to putting it in, you're going to look at the date code, which is down in this area at the bottom. There's a long serial number, and at the end there's 3 digits. This particular one is marked 125, which would be December for 12 and 5 for 2015. Once you've got your new sensor and you have your cap here, the next step is to look at the outside circumference of that sensor. That sensor has 3 ribs on one side, 2 on the other. Those correlate or correspond to the plus and minus tabs on the bottom of the sensor as marked on there. There are no plus and minus markings inside of the instruments for which direction it goes. You just simply match up the 3 ribs with the 3 slots down inside and the 2 with the other side. That will give you the correct polarity. One of the things you have to remember is, once you've figured out which way this sensor is going to go in, you need to position the cap back on top of this unit so it's in a proper orientation once it's placed in the unit. Now you have the new sensor. One of the things you want to look at prior to installing this new sensor is look at the socket pins down inside the unit. There may or may not be some corrosion in there. That's not an uncommon thing. Clean as much of that off of there as you possibly can prior to installing the sensor. Next step is to install that sensor, lining up the 3 ribs with the 3 slots down in the chassis and the 2 ribs with the other side of the chassis. That's going to go in there, and even though it is polarized so that that lines up, it's not sometimes not an easy task, as you can see, trying to put this back in here. Once you've got it pressed back in place, you then reinstall the 2 hoses back onto the cap. This takes care of the mechanical part of it. You then replace the battery door, snap it back in, and then you power up the instrument. Now, once the instrument goes through its 60-second warm-up cycle, you're going to go into the menu. And in the menu, you're going to enter the date code that you recorded off of that new sensor prior to putting it in there. Instrument itself has a date code area under the setup menu, or under diagnostics. You're going to go into the diagnostics menu on the front panel, press the enter key. Once you're in there, there's one that says O2 sensor life. You're going to scroll down to that one, press the enter key again. F3 key on the front panel is a reset. It's probably going to tell you at that point, replace O2 sensor, since it has the old date from the old sensor in there. You're then going to press the F3 button, which brings up a menu that says enter O2 date code. You will scroll through and change that date code to the number that you had recorded earlier. In this case, 125 for this particular sensor. And we will scroll through to that, and once we get it set for 125, you then press the enter key. That then brings up another section that says verify the month and year on the clock. This is to make sure that the clock is set correctly. Just verify that it is correct. If it is not correct, you adjust it up and down at this point for the correct day, a month, and year of when that, what the date is in the clock. If it's okay, you just press the enter key. Your O2 sensor light screen will then show O2 sensor good. Now, the replacement of the O2 sensor on the Fire8 Insight Plus is identically the same, except if you have a long life sensor. It's a little bit different in that that sensor does not pull straight up out with the cap. What happens is you have to remove the tubing on both sides of the O2 sensor, and on this particular one, what you're going to do is it's a quarter turn of the cap to lift it off, and then you have to reach down inside and pull that sensor out. It's a polarized connection. It goes in one way. You have three pins on the bottom, match up with the pins down in the PC board. It's only going to go in one way. So once you've got it back in there again, put the new one back in, place the cap on top, do a quarter turn to the right to lock it in position, place your tubing back on. The setting of the date code for the long life sensor in the Insight Plus or the standard 2-year sensor in both the Insight Plus and the InTech basically is identically the same, except one of the things we've run across from end users is sometimes when they change out a long life O2 sensor, inadvertently somehow the type of sensor that is listed in the setup menu is incorrect, and that will give errors as you're going through the unit. But you do the same thing. You scroll down to the diagnostic menu into the O2 sensor life. You go into the reset. You set the date code accordingly. We're going to assume that this one is 125 as well. So we will change that to 125. We will then hit the enter key. Again, you get a verify month and year. Press the enter key again. It should say good. If you've changed the sensor and it does not say good at that point, you need to go into the setup menu, back out to the setup menu, and verify that the type of O2 sensor you have selected is correct. In this case, it would be the long life. You have standard and long life as your choices. You highlight in black whatever type sensor it is, hit the enter key. It'll then tell you to enter the O2 date code again in case you didn't do that already. Hit the enter key again. It'll ask for a verification of the month and year. Hit the enter key again, and at that point, you're all ready to run. Now, one of the things to remember on, specifically on the standard sensor, 24-0788, is that once you install that sensor, right out of the canister, you place it in, you do your date code change, everything's ready to go, you should hold off for at least a minimum of 1 hour prior to using that device for taking measurements, because that sensor sitting in the carton has no load. The voltage output of that sensor is going to rise dramatically sitting in that container. Once it's placed into the circuit in the instruments, it takes at least an hour for it to stabilize and come back down to a proper level. It's better if you can do it towards the end of the day and let it sit overnight, but before you use it. But if you can't wait that long, 1 hour is normally sufficient. That will keep your numbers from dropping. We've had several instances, people have changed this, they go to take a reading, and their oxygen reading keeps continuously dropping, and that's a factor of just not letting this warm up enough and stabilizing the circuit. That pretty much covers the changing of the oxygen sensors, some of the highlights. After going through it, it's a relatively simple, straightforward procedure. It is described in detail in the manuals. If you need anything other than what's in the manuals, you can always call our technical support line. We'll be glad to help you out. This is just another one of the many reasons why Bacharach is the measurable difference.